Hi my dear students, welcome to Students Reference Channel. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe the channel and click the bell icon to get notifications for the upcoming videos. And now we are going to discuss about 4-digit by 1-digit story sums. First example, a factory produces 6,738 packets of bread in a month. If there are 6 kinds of bread packets and there are equal number of packets of each kind, then how many bread packets are there of each type? So they have given number of bread packets produced in a month, and there are 6 kinds of bread packets available, and we have to find how many bread packets are there of each type. So first we have to write total number of bread packets. This is our dividend. So total number of bread packets equal to 6,738, and 6 kinds of bread packets available. So number of kinds of breads equal to 6. So we have to find number of bread packets of each type equal to 6,738 divided 6. So if divide with 6, we get 1,123. So 1,123 bread packets are there of each type. And example 2, 5,109 stickers were distributed among 7 children equally. How many stickers did each child get? How many stickers were left? So total number of stickers 5,109 and total number of children 7. How many stickers did each child get? So this is quotient, and in this question, how many stickers were left? So this is remainder. So first we have to write the total number of stickers, 5,109, and number of children equal to 7. So number of stickers each child will get equal to 5,109 divided 7. So if we divide, we get 729 as quotient and 6 as remainder. So each child will get 729 stickers and 6 stickers will be left. Exercise 5.42, solve the following story sums. A factory has 7,632 lambs. If they pack 6 lambs in each box and gives them to an orphanage, how many boxes of lambs does they gift? So they have given total number of lambs. This is our dividend, and they pack 6 lambs in each box. So number of lambs is our divisor. So we have to find number of boxes of lambs. So total number of lambs equal to 7,632. Number of lambs in each box equal to 6. So number of boxes equal to 7,632 divided 6. So 7,632 is our dividend and 6 is our divisor. And first number 7 is greater than 6. So I take 7 first. 6 ones are 6. 6 twos are 12. 12 is greater than 7. So I take 6 ones are 6. 6 ones are 6 minus 7 minus 6 is 1. Now you bring down 6. Now its value is 16. 6 threes are 18. 18 is greater than 16. So 6 twos are 12. I take this one. 6 twos are 12. 16 minus 12. 6 minus 2 is 4. 1 minus 1 is 0. Now you bring down 3. Now its value is 43. 6 sevens are 42. 6 eights are 48, and this is greater than 43. So we take 6 sevens are 42. 6 sevens are 42 minus. 3 minus 2 is 1. 4 minus 4 is 0. Now you bring down 2. Now its value is 12. 6 twos are 12. 6 twos are 12. Minus. 12 minus 12 is 0. Now the quotient is 1272. This is our answer. Thus, they gift 1272 boxes of lamps. And problem B, 8029 beads were packed equally in 7 packets. How many beads were placed in each packet? So, total number of beads 8029 and number of packets 7. We have to find number of beads in each packet. So, total number of beads equal to 8029 and number of packets equal to 7. So, number of beads in each packet equal to 8029 divided 7. 8029 is our divider and 7 is our divisor. The first number 8 is greater than 7. So, first I take 8 only. 7 ones are 7. 7 twos are 14. 14 is greater than 8. So, we take 7 ones are 7. 7 ones are 7. 8 minus 7 is 1. Now you bring down 0. Now its value is 10. 7 twos are 14. This is greater than 10. Once again, we take 7 ones are 7. 7 ones are 7. 10 minus 7 is 3. Now you bring down 2. Now its value is 32. 7 4s are 28, 7 5s are 35. 35 is greater than 32. So we can't select this one. So we select 7 4s are 28. 7 4s are 28 minus. You borrow from here. 3 becomes 2 and this 2 becomes 12. 12 minus 8 is 4. 2 minus 2 is 0. Now you bring down 9. Now its value is 49. 7 sevens are 49. So 7 sevens are 49 minus. 49 minus 49 is 0. So our quotient is 1147. This is our answer. Thus 1147 beads were placed in each packet. See, 2592 silkworms were collected from a mulberry tree. They were placed in 9 containers such that all containers had equal number of silkworms. How many silkworms were placed in each container? So, total number of silkworms they have given and number of containers. We have to find number of silkworms in each container. Okay. So, total number of silkworms equal to 2592 and number of containers equal to 9. Number of silkworms in each container equal to 2592 divided 9. 2592 is the dividend and 9 is the divisor. And here the first number 2 is less than 9. So, we can't do the division operation. So, I take 25 first. 9 2s are 18, 9 3s are 27. 27 is greater than 25, so we select 9 2s are 18. 9 2s are 18 minus. So I borrow from here, 2 becomes 1 and this 5 becomes 15. 15 minus 8 is 7. 1 minus 1 is 0. Now you bring down this 9. And 9 8s are 72, 9 9s are 81. 81 is greater than 79. So, we can't select 81. So, we select 9 8s are 72. 9 8s are 72 minus. 9 minus 2 is 7. You have to remember one thing. The remainder should be always less than this divisor. Then only your problem is correct. Okay. Now, you bring down this 2. Now its value is 72. 9 8s are 72. So 9 8s are 72. Minus 72 minus 72 is 0. So now the quotient is 288. This is our answer. Thus 288 silkworms were placed in each container. The last problem D. In a nursery there are 1896 flower plants. If 8 flower plants could be kept in each shelf, how many shelves are required to keep these flower plants? So total number of flower plants 1896 and number of flower plants in each shelf is 8. So we have to find number of cells. So total number of flower plants equal to 1896. Number of flower plants in each shelf equal to 8. So number of shelves equal to 1896 divided by 8. So here 1896 is the dividend, 8 is the divisor. And the first number 1 is less than 8. So we can't divide. So I am taking 18 first. 8 ones are 8, 8 twos are 16, 8 threes are 24. 24 is greater than 18. So we take 8 twos are 16. 8 twos are 16 minus. 8 minus 6 is 2, 1 minus 1 is 0. Now you bring down 9. Now its value is 29. 8 threes are 24, 8 fours are 32. 32 is greater than 29. So we can't select 32. We select 8 threes are 29. 8 3s are 24 minus 9 minus 4 is 5, 2 minus 2 is 0. Now you bring down 6. Now its value is 56. 8 7s are 56 minus 56 minus 56 is 0. So now our quotient is 237. This is our answer. Thus 237 shelves are required to keep these flower plants. So my dear students, now we have completed 4 digit by 1 digit story sum problems. If you have any doubts, you please write it in the comment box. If you like this video, please like, share and comment, and don't forget to subscribe the channel. We will meet in the next class. Thank you.